Hi, I'm Max Dalton, and in this video, we're going to talk through how to enable remote access on your Plex Media server. The first thing you need to do is ensure your Plex Media server is assigned a static IP on your network. While these instructions vary from router to router, you should be able to navigate to a PC LAN section within your router's portal and locate where to reserve an IP address for a specific device. Here are the instructions for how to reserve an IP address for your Plex server in a Netgear router. Open your web browser and navigate to routerlogin.com. This is the portal for your Netgear router. Click the Advanced tab on the home page, and then click Setup beneath WPS Wizard on the left side of the screen. A fly-down menu appears. Click LAN Setup. The LAN Setup screen appears on the right. Click Add in the Address Reservation section. The Address Reservation table appears, containing a list of devices on your home network. Select the machine hosting your Plex server, and then click Add. You'll be directed back to the LAN Setup screen, where you'll see the device you selected has been added to the Address Reservation section. Write down the number associated with your device in the IP address section. You'll need this later in the process. Now we'll move on to port forwarding. Now that you've given your Plex server a static IP address, you need to set up port forwarding. Port forwarding is an option that lives in the advanced settings part of most routers. The instructions for setting up port forwarding for your Plex server on a Netgear router are as follows. Step 1. Log back into your Netgear router portal, and then click the Advanced tab at the top. Next, click Advanced Setup in the menu on the left side of the screen, and then select Port Forwarding, Port Triggering. The Port Forwarding, Port Triggering page appears on the right side of the screen. Select Port Forwarding in the Please Select Service Type section. Click Add Custom Service. The Ports Custom Services screen appears. Enter Plex in the Service Name field. You can enter anything you want, but this will make it easier to identify if you have to look for this further down the road. Select TCP/UDP in the Protocol dropdown. Set your external port range to 32400, and then check the box to use the same port range for the internal port. This will auto-populate the internal port range field with 32400. Enter the IP address that you wrote down when assigning a static IP to your Plex server. Click Apply. Congratulations, you've now completed configuring your Netgear router for enabling remote access to your Plex server. Now we can move forward with making the necessary changes to the settings of your Plex Media server. Now that you've locked in your Plex server's IP address and set up port forwarding, you can configure your remote access settings on your Plex server using the following instructions. Click Settings in the Manage section. The Settings screen appears. Click Remote Access on the left side of the screen. Click the orange Enable Remote Access button on the right side of the screen. Click to place a checkmark to the left of Manually Specify Public Port, and then enter 32400. Finally, click the orange Retry button to the right of where you entered 32400. You should now see a green checkmark to the right of Remote Access in the menu on the left side of the screen, and you should also see a green message across the top of the Remote Access window that says Fully Accessible Outside Your Network. You can now access your Plex server remotely on devices that are not in your network.